and Cleo fell out. It's over a boy.
Did you abuse my granddaughters?
I'm sorry, I haven't tried hard enough. Of course Jade can stay and we'll make it work.
Yeah. Look, Mum, there's another schoolgirl he's been luring in. Jade Albright.
Jaden?
Didn't you stay at yours last night?
Gotta get out of here. You're the only person in the world that can help. Please. I'm begging you, Pete.
What did the doctor say?
Those water tablets she kept taking. Medical acts.
And she's been injecting herself with hormones. It's given her a blood clot.
Oh, she was that desperate to lose weight.
But she's gonna be all right, though, isn't she?
Yeah. They've given us some blood thinner.
Right, well, I think it's time. We need to go to the police about Pete.
But we've got his laptop. That'll prove that...
Prove what?
Pete hasn't done anything wrong. If you talk to the police, then they're just going to treat him like he's a criminal.
He is a criminal. And he'll do it to somebody else if we don't report what he did to us.
Us? I thought he only kissed you. Did more than that, didn't he?
Only happened the once. I got away before he could do it again. And that's exactly what I'm going to tell the police. So please, come on, let's go. I'm staying here.
Come here.
Hey, can't you see I'm busy?
Oh, yeah, you're busy, all right. Busy juggling two husbands?
You better not tell Dirk.
And what is there to tell Sydney? Unless, of course, you haven't filed the papers like you said you did.
Of course I filed...
Where is my decree? Absolute...
I told you I'm chasing it up.
Smashing display. You should be jazzing up laughing egg trays down Selfridge's, talent like yours.
Cindy, this is Nita, my fiancé.
Hiya.
Hi.
She's learning French.
Oh, I've always dreamed of honeymooning in Saint-Tropez. Oh, and I will when this one finally makes an honest woman of me.
Yeah, we're all in good time, darling. Right, sir, we better shoot, yeah?
Oh, see ya.
Sorry, we're here
to report my husband. He's a sex offender.
Hey.
You're my hero.
Yeah, 12 hours too late by the looks of it. Did you sleep rough in there last night?
Oh, no, I found a shed on an allotment. Had a gas heater in it and all.
Oh, you're living the dream, aren't you?
I will be once you take me there. It's one of my old foster families. They'll look after me.
Oh, I don't know, Jade. I should take you back to the Osbournes. Jack's going to be worried sick.
No, you can't. They don't even want me. It's half an hour away, tops.
First time I laid eyes on you, I knew you'd be trouble.
So you'll take me, yeah? Oh, go on. Just say yes.
Still going to voicemail.
Because she left her phone here. Took half her clothes, though. Jack Osbourne?
Yes.
Jade Albright's foster parent.
Yes, come in.
Thank you.
What is it? What's happened to her?
Oh, no, don't worry. We just want to have a chat with her. We're trying to track down a person of interest called Peter Buchanan.
Person of interest?
Well, there's a number of messages on his laptop from Jade, so we thought she might have some idea of his whereabouts.
Thing is, we don't know her whereabouts. I feel terrible about this, but she thought I didn't want her here.
Sorry, when did you last see her?
Yesterday evening.
What has Pete done?
He's been accused of sexually assaulting an underage girl.
I'm not one for uninvited house guests.
Well, you should be, with decor as fine as yours. You know, this must be the most tastefully furnished interior in the village. Oh, wow, colour-coded. And alphabetized. That is no mean feat.
Stop buttering me up and out with it.
I need a decree absolute like now.
Do I look like a court clerk to you?
Oh, not a real one, just a fake.
So I'd help you break the law because...
Because I'm begging you. Mac will tell Dirk about us if I can't prove that I've got an annulment.
Tell Dirk yourself. He'll never leave you. Honestly, Cindy, I have never seen a man as mad about a woman. Dirk's totally besotted with you.
Yeah, which is why I can't risk it. Can't you just knock me up something 100% real looking?
Cindy, you can't just knock up annulment papers. They're official court documents. Give me a minute. Hey, hot stuff. Everything okay?
I loved him so much. And the girls loved him. When he moved in, I felt like God was saying, I know I've put you through some pretty tough times. But here you go. This will make up for it. The perfect man. And all the time, Pete was just waiting. Waiting for his chance. I swear I had no idea.
Mum was always treating me like I was still 10. But Pete... Pete knew all of my favourite bands. Put me beers on the sly. It made me feel grown up. It made me feel like I had... Like I wanted it.
So when Portia first told you...
Pete said she led him on.
So he admitted abusing her?
No. Do you think I'd have let him stay if he had? No, the first time. She just said that she kissed him. He said it was all her and that she tried it on and he'd pushed her away. It wasn't until this summer that she told us he did more.
It was only afterwards I knew I didn't want any of it. But I thought it was my fault. I thought it was my fault because of the sort of girl I was.
But then a few days later, she said that Pete was telling the truth after all, that it was just a kiss. She kept changing her story. I mean, who would you believe?
I should have told the truth when it first happened. I shouldn't have gone along with any of his lies.
I took his side, because I never saw anything. Not with any of my girls.
I am a good mum, Ridley. And I'd do anything to protect them. But I didn't know. I promised.
You'll get him, right? What? I thought the computer was going
to
help.
It is helping. It led us to Jade Albright.
Jade?
We believe she's with him now.
Are you sure this is the right road? The sign back
there. Since when have you had a driver's license?
How hard can it be? You just stop, go left, right? Even a bloke can do it.
Right, clever clogs. Just hang on there, will you? I've got to make a work call. Vince. Hi, yes, Pete. Yeah, good, mate, good. I was just wondering, is anybody using your villa in Spain at the moment? I could really do with using it myself. Oh, you're a ledge. Yeah. There'll be two of us.
Thank you. Maybe there's something here that'll help us find her.
Well, we don't even know if she's with Pete. She could be anywhere.
What have you got there? That's probably for the other phone. She had two phones. She said a boy at school gave her the second one, but...
It was probably Pete. I bet she's taken that one. Is there a number on the box?
Yeah. Oh, it's gone to voicemail.
Mom? I'm sorry for scaring you.
Why'd you risk your life with those injections? Please tell me Pete never touched you.
No. No. At least get him.
I mean, the sergeant was dead nice and everything, but I don't think what we said will be enough to send him down.
So he could get away with it.
Well, I've changed my story so many times, I'm not exactly the star witness, am I?
Cleo could be.
Yeah, well, whatever she said to Harry, he must have thought he was with her when she was a kid, so... She needs to give her statement to the police.
I'm not giving a statement. Pete hasn't done anything wrong. We love each other. You can't lock him up for that.
Oh. I knew I shouldn't have bought an old banger. Looks like the radiator. You can fix it, right? And cars are easy, you know. Stop, go, left, right.
Jade, it's Lisa. Call me. And if you're Pete, get away from him now. He's dangerous. The police are after him.
What do you think you're doing freaking me out like that? Look, Pete's my friend. He's helping me unlike you.
He's not your friend. He's a pervert. People are saying he's been with Cleo when she was your age.
Are you serious?
Where are you? Run! Now!
Right, little fidget, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get comfy.
Yeah, good call. Might be here for some time, I reckon. I'm sure we can keep ourselves entertained.
Portia, I really am. But what me and him have got is totally different. So just leave me alone.
Please. This is your fault. If you'd just listened to what I told you in the first place, if you'd have actually believed your own daughter rather than your two-faced fiancé, then maybe you could have saved Cleo from this.
Me? You waited till now to tell the full truth about Pete. You're as much to blame for this as I am. Oh, Portia, no, I'm sorry that came out wrong. Forget I ever said it. I'm a useless mum.
Yeah, you are. You have no clue, dear. How it felt having his sick, sweaty hands all over me. And then watching my own mum kissing the man that did it. Loving him. Trusting him. Can you imagine what that does to a girl?
I'm so, so sorry.
You know, I wish I'd have been wrong.
Portia, if I try really hard and I prove that I can be a good mum, do you think there's any chance that in time you could forgive me?
Jade, we didn't do you. I'm so sorry we made you think we didn't want you. We do.
Dad, let's find him and make him pay.
Darren, the police will take care of that.
No way. Look, you said you left him by the car. How far down the road?
He'll be long gone.
Please, don't make me go back. I just want to go home.
Yeah, come on.
Don't give me that look. I need some after the day we've all had.
Where's Nana?
She's not taking this well, love.
What happens if I talk to her? Just
tell her that all these stories about Pete are a load of rubbish?
No.
Well, if she's upset...
Just leave it be. Sorry, I'm not angry with you about any of this. Neither's your Nana. We both know Pete's to blame for all of this.
Pete, remind me who it was who barged into my school, into my classroom, because they were that off the face. Who fell down the city walls because they were that boozed up they could barely walk. You did. Pete took me away from all that. He sorted me out, sorted the whole family out, and cleaned up the mess that you kept making. He's a hero, but you're just too jealous to see it, Mum.
Like, that's going to help everything.
At least Celine's on the mend, eh? Doctor says she'll be home next week.
Failed her. Failed all of them.
Weren't you?
Of course you told me what Pete was.
Yeah, and no one believed her.
But I should have. Me of all people. I should have seen the signs.
Signs? But what do you mean?
What Borsha went through. And Cleo. It happened to me too. After you left home. Derek.
Mum's Derek.
I just kept my mouth shut. It's just for the sake of... For the sake of the family. I didn't want to cause any hassle.
Oh, Weenie. Why didn't you tell me? I'd have sorted him. I'd have protected you.
I thought all abusers were like him. Violent and nasty and drunk. Pete, he was a hero. He was the best thing that ever happened to me. There's no way that he could have...
I can't get my head round this either.
You did to my girls what Derek did to me. Going after what he wanted, night after night. And I let him.
It weren't your fault. You didn't know what we're at.
Well, what if there's a part of me that did know? Hey! Mum wouldn't hear a bad word about Derek, and I was exactly the same about Pete. You and Porsche spoke to me, I shut her down!
You listen to me now. Listen! What Pete did. What Derek did. You are not to blame for.
You're going to drive yourself mad on what ifs. Your daughter's... They need you here and now, and you can love them, and look after them, and protect them.
Hell.
Darling, can you do me a favour, clear the patio tables?
Do the sweep.
Thanks, baby.
The rubbish at that court, they had the papers the whole time. They just hadn't bothered to call me.
Better late than never, I guess.
Want to know where we've just been? Trawling the B427 to rescue this girl from your pedo husband.
What, you really taking her?
Like you didn't know what he was. As bad as he is.
Thank you.
And believe me, whatever you heard, I want you to be a part of this family.
You already are.
And I promise you, we won't let you down again.
So, Jade, Pete didn't do anything.
Jade, when Dia Strait gets here, she's going to ask you the same questions, love. And Lisa, I reckon it would be better if it was only family here for that.
Yeah, sure. Glad you're okay, Jade.
Pete didn't touch me. He didn't even want to take me with, but I kept on at him until he said he would.
Well, if that's all he did, they won't charge him. You know, I told you we should have gone after him ourselves.
Darren, will you give up on that one, please?
Give it up? He's still out there, Dad.
Well, what else are we meant to do?
But we let him stay in our home. Someone's got to do something.
Darren, come back here. Darren!
Did you call your solicitor?
Shh. He's going to sort the annulment as soon as.
Have I got it?
No. You are in big trouble, mister. I have been alone behind this bar for the last half an hour. Where'd you disappear to, Super Play?
Nita, it was meant to be a surprise, a happy one, I promise you.
Mac, you know I hate surprises, even happy ones. Nisha may, me. Surprisement, pa.
Oh, just spill, Mac. We could all do with some good news here right now.
Yeah, go on, spill.
All right, if you insist. Now, I have just been to see the perfect venue for us to get married in, and I have booked it for January the 7th.
Looks like you better sort that annulment soon. Otherwise, you'll be turning Mac into a bigamist, too.
Support information for the issues raised can be found online at channel4.com/support.